in the air, isn't it? It's over. It's done. That's what they want us to think right now. They want us to feel like any moment he's going to concede. Do not believe it. Do not believe it. Why should we start believing the media now? They have been lying to us for so, so long. There are pathways available. Their lies have been self-serving here. You know, I went back. I went way back to find the last time I actually believed anything the mainstream media had to say. I had to go back a little bit, and I finally found that moment when they held almost universal credibility.
So I think Barbara has an important announcement.
Yes, I do. In the state of Hawaii, with 4 electoral votes, those votes have gone to Carter, and that does it. ABC now projects Carter is the winner with 272 electoral votes. We had wondered which one of us was going to make this announcement. It was the one who got the last projection, and it's the 4 Hawaii votes that, on our account, has put Carter over the top. By our projection, James Earl Carter, the next president of the United States.
You know, because of moments like that, when we believe them, we almost have a muscle memory to turn on the television and believe what they tell us on election night or early the next morning about what happened on election day. But take a look at these folks and let's review where they have brought us during the Trump presidency and even before it. Number one, they told us Donald Trump would never be the nominee. Number two, they told us that Donald Trump could never beat Hillary. Then they told us that Donald Trump was a traitor and colluded with Russia. More recently, they've told us that Hunter Biden is only an optics issue. They insist that Mr. Biden, the father, Joe, that he doesn't have dementia. They've also tried to tell us that Donald Trump said that Nazis are nice people. And they told us that Donald Trump would lose by 14 points. And since the election, they're really hitting this one hard.
They are coming out and briefing. They have not seen widespread fraud as of yet.
We're going to fact check this in real time for you tonight because that's not the case. We don't have any evidence of illegal votes in this country.
And there's just no evidence of voter fraud in American elections.
There is no evidence of significant fraud happening in Philadelphia or any place else.
You know, most of the people you just saw all make more than $1 million a year, and they're full of themselves. I mean, you can see that. And they're in the position now that you've got to bring the evidence to them. It has to be presented to them. They're not going to leave downtown Washington, D.C. or midtown Manhattan to go out and find it. And by the way, the reporters who are out on the street, they're just busy looking at themselves on social media. No one is actually out there doing real reporting, trying to uncover voter fraud. Yet, reports do get through, don't they? And if you look closely, and if you have been looking closely, you can see them almost every day.
You have been charging for months that mail-in balloting is going to be a disaster. You say it's rigged. I said it's going to lead to fraud.
This is going to be a fraud like you've never seen.
And it goes on to the end of the theme from The Lone Ranger, whatever that is, the William Tell Overture. It goes on and on and on. And now that the election is happening, yes, we are finding real results, real flawed results from this election. Michigan officials earlier today.
Antrim County, ballots were counted for Democrats that were meant for Republicans, causing a 6,000 vote swing against our candidates. The county clerk came forward and said tabulating software glitched and caused a miscalculation of the votes. Since then, we have now discovered that 47 counties use this same software in the same capacity.
Isn't that something? That's a lot of votes. Now Pennsylvania, they really want to just hurry up and call it. You do know they changed all the rules in the run-up to the election. And look at how close it is right now. Let's put that up on the big screen. Let's see. We've got a 15,000 vote difference, and the mainstream media, they seem to be on the verge of calling this thing, even while they're still counting votes. And even, as we all know, there could be very serious problems in Philadelphia. A lot of anomalies. At least, I think we should take a moment and check it out, don't you? I keep hearing, well, we have to call this for the good of the country, for the good of the country. Donald Trump should be gracious and be a patriot and for the good of the country accept these results that they so desperately want. The country's fine, by the way. We have all kinds of systems. We have all kinds of time. Inauguration Day isn't until January 20th, 2000. We went through this for about 6 weeks. Yes, time is of the essence, but we can do multiple things at one time. Lots of people are interested in this. Let's find out what really happened. How does that sound? Okay, I think it's reasonable. Meanwhile, Joe Biden. I think Joe Biden really was telling the truth. He doesn't do it often, but we have to pay extra special attention to this very interesting moment that has been mostly overlooked.
We have put together, I think, the most extensive and inclusive voter fraud organization in the history of American politics.
It's just Joe being Joe. That's an interesting moment, don't you think? Here's what's happening. I'm told that they've been a little bit too aggressive in moving some of these votes around. Low-level people got carried away. And if this investigation and these lawsuits are allowed to go forward, we may find out some very interesting things, that perhaps they got a little bit too greedy, that this whole scheme turned out to be a little bit too successful. And that's why some of these Democrats, have you noticed? They're not actually gloating right now. They're keeping a low profile. Now, you could say that's very statesmanlike, or perhaps they know something and they're wary of being caught. It reminds me of a story. I'm going to change a couple of names and leave out a couple of facts to protect the guilty. But I know somebody was applying for a graduate program at a university. They had to take a Spanish test to see what level they would be assigned. Anyway, they weren't that good in Spanish. So they had a native Spanish speaker take the test. Guess what? The native Spanish speaker aced the test. So this person found themselves in advanced honors Spanish. That was a bit of a problem. I think that they got a little bit carried away with these vote shenanigans, and I think we're going to find them. Reminds me of that scene in Goodfellas, actually.
Is she gorgeous? I bought it for my wife. It's a coupe. I love that car.
Listen, what did I tell you? Talked to you before, didn't I? Didn't I say what's going on? Didn't I say not to go buy anything for a while?
Are you stupid or what? Did you hear what I said? Don't buy anything, don't get anything, nothing big. Did you hear what I said? What's the matter with you?
He was worried that they were bringing too much attention to themselves. They had just robbed the Lufthansa hangar at Kennedy Airport, stole $5 million. I've sensed something similar is going on here. They got a little bit carried away, and they're worried they could get caught. Now, I could be wrong, but let's take some time here and find out what really happened, huh? Is that a good idea? I think so. Now, Joe Biden, well, let's face it, Joe Biden is something of, I don't know, he's just a vehicle for these folks. We don't hear from him. We barely heard from him in the campaign. I mentioned last night that his lack of campaigning told me that he probably knew something was up. And you know what? This goes way back to early in his career. He was the kind of guy who would do business with you, if you know what I mean.
Senator Biden, welcome to The Advocates.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Senator Biden, it's nice to have you here. As the youngest member of the Senate, the one, therefore, who may expect the longest career there, I wonder if you'd say to us, since it's clear that you're not corrupt and you got elected, why should people think that the system produces corrupt results when there you are?
Well, I'm not sure you should assume I'm not corrupt, but thank you for that, though.
That was totally weird and unfunny. Look at that. Don't assume I'm not corrupt. It actually gets worse from there. Now, Donald Trump went with the promise to drain the swamp. Joe Biden seems totally at home and happy in the swamp. Listen to what comes next.
The system does produce corruption, and I think implicit in the system is corruption, when in fact, whether or not you can run for public office, and it costs a great deal of money to run for the United States Senate, even from a small state like Delaware, you have to go to those people who have money, and they always want something.
And Joe seems fine with that. And Joe, what happened? Did he change? He just got a little friendlier looking. A little bit friendlier looking, but he's still a wise guy. Let's see. He evolved. Yeah, there he is. I think that's what happened. He looks grandfatherly, but he's still a bit of a hotshot. At least he fancies himself one. And you know what? A lot of times he seems afraid, afraid of being caught. Did you see this during some of the town halls? There are a lot of times where he shows absolute terror. I mean, we've seen Donald Trump now for almost 4 years, 5 years counting the campaign. You could look at all the footage. You would never find an image like that where he's afraid, afraid of a question from an ordinary person. Because unlike the media, ordinary people, you never know what they're going to ask. They might just ask about Burisma and Hunter and the laptop. Is it Hunter's? And did you meet with that Burisma officials? Every time Joe meets a civilian, a question like that could come up. All right. So where are we? I think there are lots of avenues. You know, the lawyers are working on this. They're all over the country. I know it's complicated, but just look at Pennsylvania. 15,000 votes and, oh, the pressure is on to call it. I don't think so, and I don't think our president is going to do that either, even though I do hear some insiders right now are urging him to do that. Keep in mind, these insiders are creatures of the swamp. For the most part, Donald Trump got to the swamp without the swamp, if that makes sense. He basically did it by himself, and now he has these people, a lot of them who came of age down there. I hope he has a good wartime consigliere. But giving up is just not what this guy does.